Hello again. This is our second problem solving with pulley systems when we determine the acceleration of a pulley system. And we are moving to the second situation that I presented to you in the previous series of YouTube videos, which is another Atwood machine that now has three objects. M1, M2, and M3, and the condition given is that M3 is greater than M1 plus M2, because M3 is greater than the sum of M1 and M2, this whole system will accelerate counterclockwise, which is going to become our positive direction automatically. The forces you see here, I already introduced to you. I showed you how to draw the free body diagrams for this kind of Atwood machine. Just very fast, as a reminder, magnitude check must be done always. The first thing we have to check for this is if the tensions in the two strings are the same. So T1 here must be the same in magnitude as T1 there. And they are. And then this T2 here in blue must be the same as this T2 here in blue, because this is another string that's connecting M2 and M1, but the pull is the same no matter where we measure it in magnitude. So T2 here seems to be 3 centimeters, and this one also 3 centimeters, so we are good with checking the magnitudes of the tension forces all around. Now let's go ahead and check for balanced and unbalanced forces. In this case, all forces must be unbalanced because the whole system accelerates. So for M3, M3G should be greater than T1, since this object accelerates downward. And M3G is 9 centimeters, while T1 is 5, 9 is greater than 5. For M1, T2 should be greater than M1G because M1 accelerates upwards. T2 is 3 centimeters, while M1G is only 2, so I'm good there as well. M2 has T1 pulling upward, T2 pulling downward, and M2G also going downward. T1 must be greater in magnitude than the sum of T2 and M2G. While T1 is 5 centimeters, T2 is 3, and M2G is 1.8. So 3 plus 1.8 is 4.8, 5 is greater than 4.8, so I'm good there with the unbalanced forces. Now it's time to move on to writing the equations for the three objects. Remember, all these forces, again, are only one-dimensional, so we don't have F net X and F net Y, we only have F net. However, we have F net 1 and F net 2 and F net 3. For object M1, we have F net 1 equals M1A. For object M2, we have F net 2 equals M2A. And for M3, we have F net 3 equals M3A. The acceleration is the same for all objects in any kind of pulley system. Now we are going to remember that F net is the vector sum of all the forces, so therefore we are going to consider the vectors for each of these objects and their directions according to the positive direction that we have in the diagram up there. For F net 1, this is it, we have a positive T2 that will be added to a negative M1G to give me M1A. So when I plug those in here, color coded, T2 is positive in blue, M1G is negative in black. And I simplify this, I'm going to get T2 minus M1G equals M1A. For the second object, we have three forces. One is positive, two are negative, so we're going to have a vector sum of three forces equals M2A. Well, the three forces are positive T1 over there, color-coded in green, and then two negative forces. T2 is negative, so negative T2 in blue, and so is M2G, negative in black. Simplifying this gives us T1 minus T2 negative M2G equals M2A. And I will do the same thing for the third object over here. This one has two forces acting upon it, whose vector sum must be equal to m3a. The two forces are positive m3g and negative t1. When we simplify this, we get the scalar equation m3g minus t1 equals m3a. And now when we look at these three equations, we realize that the masses are given, so is little g, but we don't know t1 and t2, and we don't know the acceleration. However, we don't need t1 and t2, we only need the acceleration, so we would like to eliminate t1 and t2, and it should be quite obvious that if you add up the three equations, the left-hand sides and the right-hand sides, t1 and t2 will cancel out, negative t2 here, positive t2 here, negative t1 here, positive t1 there. So let's do that. Let's add up the three equations. First, the left-hand sides, t2 minus m1g plus t1 minus t2 minus m2g plus m3g minus t1 equals m1a plus m2a plus m3a. Let's just factor out an a, and then we have within parentheses the sum of the three given masses. So then t1 and negative t1, negative t2 and positive t2 cancel out. We have left these three terms on the left-hand side. I'm going to factor out a g there. And within parentheses, I'm going to start with my positive term, which is m3, and then negative m2, and then negative m1 equals a times the sum of masses. And now by simply dividing both sides by the sum of masses, we end up having our TBD finalized here. m1 plus m2 plus m3 goes in the bottom of my fraction, g in the front of the whole fraction, and in the top I'm going to have m3 minus m2 minus m1 circle, and that is our final answer for this second case of Pulley systems. Thank you.